Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. I am finally back from my holiday and from my recovery from my holiday. I had to strictly get in order myself after this holiday. It was most amazing time I spent on any holiday in my life. My mommy enjoyed it, I enjoyed it. I never had holiday like this. When someone, somebody else take care about you, when somebody else is cooking and cleaning your room, and in a beautiful country with amazing people around. I met one of our craft friend, Despina Mico, which is, by the way, very, very talented lady. I really hope she will decide to make videos for YouTube, because she's amazing artist. I saw her stitching. She've got few, those wall pictures, they are huge, really huge, and she stitched them herself, and they are amazing, amazing. And I saw her journal, her personal journal, and it's really gorgeous. It's very artistic, and it's gorgeous. So, by the way, hi Despina, hi girls, I miss you so much, girls. Every day I'm thinking, oh, I want to go back, because here is too cold, and in Greece it's amazing weather, and it's so gorgeous. So I had beautiful time, and after I came back to England, I've been crafting a little bit here and there. I made my design team projects, and today I'm going to share with you design team project for Dreams Etc. and for Jennifer's latest collection, which is called Black Swan. This collection, it's amazing. It's full of gorgeous, gorgeous colors. Even I am a person who is more in grungy. I love this collection. Here is pink, which I thought I don't like, but in this collection, I love that color. It's in a very beautiful shade of pink, very gorgeous lilac, purple, gray, and black colors all together, and it makes so gorgeous collection. And I made those two journals. This is in kind of new style, and this one, it's kind of vintage style. And by the way, sorry for my hands, I try to wash it up. I'm coloring, I'm trying to do French decoupage on cans, and hopefully it will be okay, but I will see when it will dry. In both of those journals, I made weekly planner. Here, I've got it in here. This can be take off, like this, and it's very simple weekly planner. It looks like this. I coffee dyed those papers, and as you can see, here can be at so many pockets, tags, everything you want. And here in this journal, I fix it on the page, and I made it in very clear new style. I didn't coffee dye those papers, but still, they look amazing, and I'm gonna show you what I used for this. I found in Poundland for £1 this weekly planner. This is table weekly planner. You can left it on your table and open it like this. So I just folded every single page. Then I put them between two wooden plates with that folding part on this side between two wooden plates. I fix it. That end, I left a little bit in the air, and I used PVA glue on that on those edges, and then I glue it to my cover. It was very easy. You just need to wait till that PVA glue here will dry on that spine, and make it 2-3 times that coat, and I glue it again. Just this first page I glued on this side, and then last page I glued on this side, and here it's gap, so I can open this really well. It's nothing hold me down, so it's very easy, and it was really fast to make that basic. And now I'm going to show you this vintage file folder journal. So here you can see that planner. It can be carried separate from all this book in your handbag. Here is just small pocket made out of glossy back, and I decorated with those gorgeous images from this beautiful collection. As you can see, all those images, they are so soft, beautiful, just stunning, stunning. And here I used one, I think it's called those mood boards. You can find them on Pinterest, on Google. There is hundreds of those mood boards. So I cut out those images and I use it here. It's, by the way, like my small booklet. And here you can see, I glue it upside down. It's supposed to be like this, but oops. So it's like back way. So this is my very simple planner. So you've got always 1 week and then two blank pages for another notes. And again, 1 week and two blank pages. So it's great space for journaling, for writing notes, for gluing your pockets, tags, and everything else. And here I've got my vintage book for this planner. Here, by the way, here, this is my my flower I made. And it's made out of zips. Do I have some zip here around me? I don't have. I will remember that for next video. I will show you what I made. It's zip. I just separated on those two parts, on those two sides, left and right, and then I roll it like rows. It was two, I think, this piece of that zip, and it makes a so gorgeous rose puppet. So I use it here. This is one of those gorgeous pages from this Black Swan collection, and this is my first page. I made large pocket here. I used those beautiful note pages, which I bring from my country. They are really vintage, really antique. Oops. I stuck behind that lace with my paper clip. So I made very large pocket here. So anything can be stored here. And as you can see, I used this gorgeous girl like decoration. I used loads of laces in this journal. And here I've got my decorated paper clip. Again, I used those clear stones like my decoration. I just glued them on leftovers from this gorgeous collection, and I'm using them like decoration. And I print out this collection in a few different sizes to be able to make small tags with those tags which are on one sheet in this collection. There is Be the Best You Can Be. Here is another one on this tag. Create with all your heart, with all of your heart. And I made like small embellishments out of those gorgeous tags. Here, it's one tag you can print out on one sheet. There are, I think, 3 or 4 tags. Here is one, here is another one. You will see that when you will go to check out this collection. As you can see, it's really gorgeous. It's amazing. And those colors are so, so gorgeous. And here I made pockets for some goodies. Here is just small ephemera. It's like, advertising. My English is brilliant today. Here is envelope you can print out. It looks like this. And it's really gorgeous, really gorgeous. So you can facet out all those images if you wanna make some layout. So this is envelope you can print out. Sorry. And here I made like small file folder. It looks like this one. I use those vintage notepapers. Here is like tag spot, so you can slide your own image. And I use just this gorgeous image of those swans. Here I made it's like flip, maybe for your images, for some writing. Here is another ephemera. It's like pocket, and also pocket, it's behind this. So it's small. Oops. It's small folder. Come on. It's in this pocket here. I think I'm gonna place it on the side because I will make mess. Here I've got another page. This is made out of envelopes. I've got here this tag. I decorated well. I've got a new, my new die. I purchased loads of dies, and I will put link for this shop down below. It's called Every Craft Pound, and it's here in UK. So for crafters from here in UK, it will be really good to go to check out this shop, because their prices are brilliant, and they've got so many gorgeous items, gorgeous craft supplies. I'm not sure if they are sending overseas, and I'm not sure if it will be worth it, because you know that shipping costs loads of money. But for UK people, it's brilliant shop. So I will put link down below. And also I will put link down below for one US shop, which is sending to UK with free shipping. And they've got brilliant prices. It's called, I think, Big Warehouse or something like this. I will put those links down below, so you can go check out their items. So this is one tag I've got. And here it's another tag you can print out from this collection. And I made it again like booklet. And it's in this pocket here. And I've got, oh, here you can see those gorgeous papers. And I've got pocket behind, here I've got another pocket. I made out of envelope. And here I've got just small note. And yeah, I've got so many leftovers, those bits and pieces. So I made smaller layout. I embossed this cardstock. I used this gorgeous paper and I embossed it with my embossing folder, and I made this small tag, and it's in this pocket. Oops, go there. And then when you turn it here, it's that other side, and it's open here. Open down, open to this side and to that side. So it's like gate. And I used two those long envelopes on those sides. Here you can see flaps from those envelopes. And I used two envelopes this side. One envelope is folded down over that another envelope. It's very easy to put it together, really very easy. And as you can see, I used all those gorgeous papers. So here, behind that flaps, I've got this, how you have to tie those shoes, those ballerinas' shoes, which I found, I think, on Pinterest. Here I've got few images with ballerinas. I've got a few images on other side as well. Those gorgeous dresses. And here it's tag, which you can print out for, with this this collection. And here in this pocket, I've got another tag I create. Again, I embossed that basic and I put those leftovers with decoration over that. And here you can see another paper. It's really gorgeous, gorgeous paper. And I think I've got something. Yes, I've got. Yeah, here is mood board. I print out with ballerinas. Oh, sorry. Like this. Here are gorgeous ballerinas. And all those gorgeous images. So it's in all those pockets. I'm gonna. Oops. Close it. Oh, and also I've got, by the way, pocket here. And again, I used piece of this gorgeous collection here, just small ballerina girl. I hope you don't have there so much glare from my light over there. Here is another, I like this one, with this soft swan. Here, those two images, those two ephemeras. It's closing like this. I'm going back to those shops, that Every Craft Pound. Someone asked me about that varnish, coffee dyed varnish I found. And I can't find again that seller, but this shop, Every Craft Pound, they've got it. This tea dye varnish, Paper Plus. I'm guessing Paper Plus, it's company who made it, probably non-toxic, made in USA. And here is, here is a web page, so I will put that web page, rubber stampede.com. I will put that web page down below for USA people. Maybe they will have this tea dye varnish. It's really brilliant, and I use it on that sheet with how you can tie your shoes, those ballerina's shoes. So you can try to find it somewhere somewhere in USA. But I found it in that Everycraft Pound. They've got this one. So here we've got another page. Here it's another beautiful, gorgeous envelope from this collection. And I made closure, just this circle. And I used few layers. And I decorated with those balls. Hopefully I've got some. Oh, yeah, God, yay, yeah. I've got those teeny, meeny pieces here. And it's closing like this. Just slide it behind. And it's really beautiful. And here I've got another half pocket. I used, like decoration, this gorgeous ballerina. And I used few of my leftovers. And it's very simple half pocket. And here, another my tags. This is another my decoration. And yes, this dye, I think I didn't finish that sentence before. This dye I purchased in that Everycraft Pound for £1. It's brilliant. They've got Christmas selling, so go to check out. Now I'm gonna continue, hopefully. I decorated like this, nearly similar way like that tag before. And here I made pocket for my triple pocket. Here I made pocket using those gorgeous papers. Look at that. It's amazing. It's really amazing. And I made triplet, or how you call it that, with pockets. Here this ephemera. It is gorgeous. It's Vogue Girl, Vogue Ballerina. And here this tag, or like this. It depends how you want to put it in. And all those beautiful papers. And this is from other side. They are really gorgeous, 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 gorgeous. And all this I've got in this pocket. And all this is going to this pocket. It's so many pockets. And here we've got, I made large envelope using those gorgeous papers. Here I placed few, I'm not sure if you will see that, those are dimensional roses. I placed them exactly on those printed roses. Hopefully you will see that. And I used Tim Holtz lavender, I'm guessing right. Yeah, that, millet lavender dye on the top. I just dip it on the top of my roses and it's matching together. So if you will use this distress ink around your edges, it will just brilliant. It will be just brilliant. And here in this large envelope, which I made using this gorgeous collection, I made this small like booklet or folder. I'm in love with folders, so I'm folding everything now. And I use those gorgeous papers. Here is another envelope. Here I didn't put any embellishment because I want to get flat. So here is another envelope, but look at that. It's so gorgeous. Jennifer made amazing job. She's always doing amazing job with her collections. She's amazingly talented artist. And I watched her when she's coloring, when she's painting pictures. And it's really wow. It's stunning. She's so talented. And here I've got this picture. And it's closing again behind that circle. Here those papers. Really brilliant papers. And here I've got again kind of multi-opening. It's open like this. And like this. It's pocket here. Large pocket here. And this. And I've got that, those two ballerinas. Beautiful ballerinas. It's in this large pocket. Hopefully I'm in view. And hopefully my mobile didn't switch off. Because this is not the first time when I'm taking this video. Here I've got Pocket and I found this gorgeous, gorgeous image. And I made those two small tags. By the way, this fluffy thing, which I used like decoration, those are... I'm working still with this collection. I'm making kind of artistic, artistic journal, but it will take time. I need some inspiration, so I place it on the side right now. But I'm using colors, and I'm coloring a lot. And I'm wiping those colors with my napkins probably. And I let them dry, and I'm using them like my decoration here, because they've got those right colors. And I think it's nice, it's like very soft. So it's my decoration here. And it's closing like this. And I've got Pocket here as well. Here you can see another gorgeous image. And here those dresses. And another decorating tag. It's like this. It's in this large envelope. I have to be much more faster. Otherwise, this video will be again so long, long, long. Here I've got small Pocket. Like slide Pocket, and I use those blinks. I start to be in love with all those girls projects. Here I've got like a small tuck spot, and I used again that piece of acetate from packaging, and I made it like my small tuck. And here is like a holder for this image, and again I decorated with beads, this tag, so it's in this pocket. And here I made page using only this small booklet. Again, I used one tag which you can print out, few laces, and it's like small booklet. It's here. And here I've got again embossed tag. I've got new embossing folder, which by the way I purchased also in that craft, Every Craft Pound. Just go to check it out, with that chandelier, and I really love that. It looks amazing. This is from that other side. This is a Marianne design die, which is really gorgeous. And I've got this feather. Look at that. I've got black feather. And this is like my embellishment. And here is like small tuck spot for those small tags, and for this gorgeous ballerina. Oh, sorry for that glare. Sorry. And it's holding with this paper clip. Go there. And from this side, I've got this. When I've been at home, I've been checking a stationery shop, of course, and I found there those. It's like a bank check, not bank check, it's like check when you own to somebody money. So you fill it down, this form, that you will pay it back at that day and to this person. And here you have to sign it. And you have to give this one to that person you own money. And I really love that because it looks gorgeous. So I coffee dyed that, and it looks... Look, it has that purple color, so I have to use it here. And I just decorated a little bit with this gorgeous lace and with those bits and pieces. And it's here. Here I've got half pocket. I use this note paper and I decorated with laces and with this gorgeous ballerina. And here you can see I printed in 8-3 size papers. So it's really large, this one. Here are those tags, those motivating tags. And here I made pocket, and here is another tag you can print out. And here again, just small decoration. It looks like this. And I've got pocket here, but I don't have anything inside. I have to put something inside. So it's in this pocket. Okay. It was somewhere this one. Oh, yay! I know, it was holding this tag. Here, I used again bits and pieces from my leftovers. I used my molds. And here, I'm not sure if you see that glare. And I'm not sure if you will see those bits and pieces. Those are those small pieces from my dies. I've been lazy to use that this and put it all those bits and pieces in my die out of my die. So I used double-sided tape. I tape it. Just a minute. Bear with me. Where is that butterfly? I lost my butterfly. Ah. I hope you will understand even if I didn't take that butterfly. Just bear with me. I'm gonna make small frame and I'm gonna show you what I mean. Hopefully I will be able to show you, probably not. But normally my paper, it's staying in those frames. And when I'm taking out all that dye, all those bits and pieces are staying inside. Normally it's happening all the time. So I took double-sided tape and I tape it over it. Oops, stay. I tape it. And I wasn't controlling what I'm doing. I just tape it over it. And then I was thinking, oh my God, I feel so sorry for those bits and pieces. Some of them looks like flower because it was stay in that shape of that butterfly's wings, which are like flowers. They look like flowers here, those wings. Here, see? This is like flower, and it was stay here on that tape. So when I had all those bits and pieces on my tape, I used sand, that very fine sand, this one. I used that very fine sand, and I went over with that very fine sand. And it made gorgeous. It made gorgeous tape. That is tricky to take it off from that basic of your double-sided tape. But if you are patient, you can take it off and glue it. See, I went with that very fine sand. And it was here are not nice piece of that, oh my God, leftovers. Oh my God, sorry for my English. But if you will have some nice pieces and you will have them here and you will use some beautiful sand, you can use it like your decoration. And it works really good. You know, I'm saving everything. So, this one, oops. I'm gonna place it here and place it there as well. So I decorate this stack, and here you can see beautiful images. And here it's my last page from this journal, and it's again like half pocket, and it has pocket here. And here you can see that frame, that small frame, which I now showed you. Here is just this ephemera, this stack, and I used in that frame another from those large tags with those mood boards. Here I'm using another those tags like decoration. And I used again leftovers and I decorated just bits and pieces. It's open like this. It's like ledger paper. Here I made small notepad. And here I put this gorgeous girl, ballerina's girl. And from other side, it's like a pocket for another tag you can print out with this gorgeous collection. And it's another booklet. And again, it has like pocket behind. So it's here. Here you can see beautiful film strip with those ballerinas. It's gorgeous. It's brilliant decoration. Oops. So it's here. And here we got weird weird notebook. It's very simple. Somehow I did it. I've been watching some video. I'm not sure which video. I don't remember that video. But I did somehow this one. And it's like accordion notebook. I have to figure it out again. How I put all together all this. And it has those tabs and few pages. And there is loads of space for editing pockets, images, etc., etc. So it's very simple, but I don't remember how I did it. And here is, sorry, pardon me. It is just this gorgeous vintage picture and this pocket. So it's in here in that last pocket in my journal. Here is another side. Pardon me. And here, not last pocket, last page. And here on that back side, I've got this large pocket. I decorated again with that paper strip. And I make it like frames around those girls. And I've got there this gorgeous tag. With pocket behind again, with those two ballerinas. Sorry for that girl, hopefully you will see that. They are gorgeous. So this is my vintage journal. This is back page where you've got where I've got this belly band, and this journal can be slide behind that belly band. Open like this, slide it behind, and close it around. So you've got all together. And I think this is already very long video, so that modern style journal I'm gonna share in next video. And then I've got a few more sharing. I've got another project to share. So hopefully you will join me next time as well. Thank you so very much for all your amazing comments. I am so afraid. I don't have a time to type it back, but I will make some notes in my language, which is much more easy and much more fast for me. I will make some notes. And in next video, I will try to answer as much as I can. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments, for all your amazing support. And people, you make me so happy. Hopefully, you like this project. I really love all those papers, all those images. I will put link down below for Jennifer's Etsy shop and also for her blog with her shop, because there is so many amazing things, so many amazing products. Go to check it out. This collection, it's gorgeous. And Jennifer has some brilliant sales on those collections, so go to check it out. This is my sharing for today. Hopefully you will enjoy. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time. Bye.